let's discuss the next concept, average atomic mass for those element which contains isotopes. So what is mean by isotope? That we already studied in standard 9. What is isotope? Same atomic number. If you observe these three carbon atoms which contain same atomic number, that is 6, which is written to the bottom side. While different atomic mass number, carbon has a 12 atomic mass number, carbon has a 13 atomic mass number, carbon has 14 atomic mass number. So these three isotopes of an carbon. So what is isotope? Same atomic number but different atomic mass number is called as isotope. Atomic number written to the bottom side, while atomic mass number is written to the top side of an element. Same here, hydrogen has three isotope, H11, H12, H13. We can write atomic mass number to the left hand side, top side, or right hand side. So this is called as hydrogen, this is called as deuterium, this is called as tritium. So these three isotopes of hydrogen are present in the atmosphere. So why this concept exists, average atomic mass? Because there are some element which contains isotopes in the nature, but for calculating atomic mass number, which atomic mass number we have to consider? Either it is 12.00, either it is 13.0035, or it is 14.315. It is depending on the actual abundance in the atmosphere. So what is the formula to calculate average atomic mass? It is very simple. Let's see the definition, then we'll discuss about formula for calculating average atomic mass. So let's see the difference. Average atomic mass of any element is the sum of the masses of their isotope, is the sum of masses of their isotopes multiplied by its natural abundance. See, carbon C12 having atomic mass is 12.00. Its abundance in the atmosphere is 98%. Means out of these three, which is present in the maximum in the nature, 98% this one. Then this is 1.108, and the last C14 is present 2 × 10⁻¹⁰. So what is the, my question is that what is the abundance of carbon in the atmosphere, or sorry, what is the average atomic mass for the carbon? So formula will be CaA. What is CaM? CaAM. Average atomic mass. Average atomic mass is what? It is the CaAM. Average atomic mass. It is the atomic mass of that element multiplied by its natural abundance. So C12 contains, what is the atomic mass? 12 multiplied by its abundance is 98.892, plus second element 13 atomic mass, 13.00335, multiplied by its abundance 1.3108. third, 14 multiplied by 14.00317 multiplied by 2 × 10⁻¹⁰. Divide by 100. By this calculation, you will get value 12.011. So what is the average atomic mass of carbon? So it is 12.011. You can calculate for any element by its isotope. What is the formula? Average atomic mass is formula. The atomic mass of that element multiplied by its natural abundance. If there are 3, we are taking 3. If there are 2, we will take 2. Next one, molecular mass. So molecular mass is for molecules of an formation of molecules which is formed by the atoms. So what is molecular mass? It is the sum of average atomic mass, as we already studied in the previous how to calculate average atomic mass, which is AAM. It is the sum of average atomic mass of any atom of an element which constitutes the molecules. If there are three atoms are present, then you have to calculate the average atomic mass of a three element. It's a very simple. Let's see the example. Calculate, question will be there. Calculate the molecular mass of carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide contains how many carbon? Only one carbon. So 1 multiplied by average atomic mass of carbon. And how many oxygen present? 2 oxygen atoms are present. So 2 multiplied by average atomic mass of oxygen. So substitute the value. 1 multiplied by, what is the average atomic mass of carbon? It is 12 plus 2 multiplied by, what is the average atomic mass of oxygen? It is 16. So it is 12 plus 32. It will be a 44 unit. It will be a 44 unit. This is your first example. We'll discuss second example. Calculate average atomic mass of water molecule. Calculate molecular mass of water. What we are dealing? We are dealing molecular mass for water. So how many hydrogen atoms are present in the water molecule? 2 hydrogen atoms are present. So what will be the formula? 2 multiplied by average atomic mass of hydrogen plus, right now how many hydrogens are present? Only 1. So 1 multiplied by average atomic mass of oxygen. Substitute the value. 2 into 1. What is the atomic mass of hydrogen? 1. What is the atomic mass of oxygen? 16. 1 into 16. So what will we get? 18 unit. What is the atomic mass of molecular mass of water? It is 18. Next example. We'll discuss chlorobenzene. Or you can write C6H5Cl chlorobenzene, written as like this. Chlorobenzene. We'll discuss how to write this organic aromatic compound in the different, do another topic. So let's discuss how many carbon atoms are present. 6 multiplied by, what is the average atomic mass of carbon? 12 plus, how many hydrogen atoms are present? 5 multiplied by, what is the average atomic mass of hydrogen? 1. How many chlorine atoms are present? 1 multiplied by, what is the average atomic mass of chlorine? 35.5. Let's calculate this value. It will be a near around 112.5 unit. Next example, calculate molecular mass of sulfur dioxide. So how many sulfur atom? Only 1 multiplied by, what is atomic mass of sulfur? It is 32 plus oxygen. How many oxygen atoms are present? 2 multiplied by 16. So what will we get? 32 plus 32. It will be a 64 unit. These are the formula to calculate molecular mass. Next, formula mass. Formula mass is for those substances in a chemistry which does not contain a discrete molecule in a continuous unit. This does not contain discrete molecules in a continuous unit. These compounds are contains three-dimensional sheet-like structure or three-dimensional cubic structure in the molecule. Let's see the example of NaCl, or we'll see first of all the definition of molecule. It is the sum of atomic masses of an atoms present in the formula. It is same like previous one. Formula for or formula mass for sodium chloride. So what is the average atomic mass of sodium? It is 23 and for chlorine it is 35.5. So 23 plus 35.5 it will be a 58.5. Let's see the second example. Calculate formula mass for copper nitrate. So what is copper nitrate? CuNO3 twice is the formula for copper nitrate, because copper has 2 plus valency while NO3 has minus 1 valency. To satisfy this copper, how many NO3 will require? 2 NO3 will require. This is minus 1, minus 1, this is plus 1, plus 1. So how many NO3? 2 NO3 is there in this compound. So what is the formula? Formula mass, number of atoms multiplied by atomic mass. So number of atoms for copper is how many number of atoms? 1. Multiplied by its atomic mass, it is 63.5 plus, see, NO3, how many NO3 present? This 2 is multiplied to whole bracket. So you can take to the front side, 2 in bracket, 14, how many nitrogens are present? Only 1 multiplied by 14, atomic mass of nitrogen, 14 plus, how many oxygen atoms are present? 3 multiplied by 16. 3 multiplied by 16. You will get 87.5 unit. Same question will be arises for different molecules. Let's consider the next, that is mole. So what is meant by mole? Mole is the one type of unit to calculate number of particles, or it is a type of unit for the atoms. So we'll see the definition first of all. Mole, one mole is the amount of substance that contains as many entities or the particles as their atoms exactly 12 gram of C12 isotopes. Carbon as a standard element, as we already studied in the previous concept. So what is one mole? So it contains exactly 12 gram of C12 isotopes. We'll discuss. So what is the mass of carbon? C12. Carbon has a 3 isotopes, C12, C13 and C14. We'll discuss about C12, which is 1.992648 × 10⁻²³ gram. But mass of 1 mole of carbon atom is 12 gram. So the number of atoms present in C12 is 12 by 1.99, so it will be 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms. What it means? It means that C12 contains or 1 mole of carbon atom contains 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms present in a molecule. One more example we'll discuss. Same, 1 mole of oxygen atom, 1 mole of oxygen atom contains how many particles or how many atoms present? So it contains again 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms present in the molecule. Same, 1 mole of nitrogen atom, 1 mole of nitrogen atom contains how many atoms? It contains 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms. Same to the all, 1 mole of water contains how many atoms? 1 mole of water contains 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms. 1 mole of sodium chloride contains how many atoms? 1 mole of sodium chloride contains 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms. This number, or 6.022 × 10⁻²³ number, is called as Avogadro's number. Very important. It's called as Avogadro's number, denoted by symbol capital N to the base capital A. It's called as Avogadro's number.